A priest or father recently made a video addressing the question, are trans women real women? It was a TikTok. He recently posted it. On this video, we will be reacting to that TikTok, to that LGBTQ TikTok. It's not going to be what you expect. You may be having a reaction that you expect us to have, but instead, we are going to react based off the Bible. This isn't going to be Gabe's reaction. This isn't going to be what Gabe thinks. This is going to be what God thinks about this TikTok, what God thinks about this man. Finally, before I show you this video that will most likely shock you, I do want to preface it with this. I strongly encourage you, please do not send hate to this man. Please do not send condemnation to this man. This video is not a clap back or an attack against this man. This is not me trying to throw criticism at the man, because the man is a broken, fallen, sinful human being, just like everyone else. And so we're not trying to criticize the man, but rather we will be addressing the content of what he said. Please keep that in mind. This is not trying to create drama. This is not trying to get you to go comment on the TikTok or anything like that, okay? Watch the video, then we'll come back.
Hello, Father. Are trans women real women? Let me make this super clear. Trans women are women. Trans men are men. Trans rights are human rights. Can I get an amen?
Right, first things first, a lot of people may be wondering, Gabe, why are you reacting to another one of these videos? The reason is because it's become so important. I actually haven't realized how widespread this thinking has become all across this world, how widespread this ideology really has become all across this world. It's become so important that we must always address it according to what the Bible says. But first, I want to address some of these comments. So many comments came in and they said that they love the Father's energy. They said, me as an atheist, amen, Father. People said, my respect went up. Another person said, I'm an atheist. I said, amen. People were saying, amen, Father. Basically, it was a lot of comments that recognized, I guess, the fact that he was a priest, the fact that he had a collar, and automatically, because he had this authority, so-called, they thought what he said was right. And that is the biggest thing that I need to emphasize to you right now. Do not accept what everyone says. Now, again, this video is not in hate towards that man. Can I be very honest with you real quickly? That man, he makes a lot of satire videos. I love him. And if you're watching this video right now, the creator of that video, I love you. I'm here for you. Anybody that's watching this video, we love you. And as Christians, we are called to love, and we are called to shape culture the way God would. However, that being said, we are not called to just accept what anybody says. And just because someone has a white collar, just because someone calls themselves something, doesn't mean that that's what God thinks. You see, God has written his thoughts toward us in this Bible. And so as Christians, as those who believe what God says, we cannot just make things up. We cannot just say stuff because we want to be culturally relevant. We cannot just say stuff just because we want to be accepted by everyone. We need to say what God says. Now, that being said, that doesn't mean we hate other people. That doesn't mean we condemn and tell people of all the wrongs they're doing. That doesn't mean we come against people just to come against people, just to fight and just to be strong. Instead, we believe what the Bible says. And I want to read to you a quick scripture. The Bible says in Mark chapter 10, Jesus Christ himself. Now, again, if you're going to watch this video and you're going to have a lot of different thoughts, you're going to say, well, Gabe, what about this? Gabe, you said this. Gabe, you thought that. Please wait till the end. Please hold your reaction. Please hold your response until you really learn what God says. Also, for anybody that's watching this video and you're about to tune off, please don't leave yet, because you want to know what God says. And also, I want to pray a prayer with you that you would be set free from the world's way of thinking, that you would think the way God would think. And we're going to pray at the end of this video. If this is your first time and you just happen to come across it, feel free to hit that subscribe button, because we do Bible studies Friday nights and Sunday nights and then Wednesdays, and we upload Bible studies here on this channel. So if you want to get closer to God, you can hit the subscribe button. Turn your notification on. I don't say that for myself, I say it for you. Okay, let's get into it. Mark chapter 10, and we're going to be looking at verse 6. Jesus said, at the beginning of creation, he was quoting Genesis, he said, God made them male and female. And then he goes on to say this in verse 7, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Then in verse 9, Jesus said, therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. All throughout the Bible, God has made his will known. All throughout the Bible, God has made his creation known. And that's not just in this scripture. It's in scriptures all across the Bible. And I want to give you another point. During that TikTok, he didn't use any scriptures. He didn't say what the word of God was. He said what his opinion was. Remember, never base your beliefs off of other people's opinions. But what you've got to learn about what this Bible says about what Jesus Christ said, it's not about what people feel. And honestly, guys, this video might get Gabe canceled. I don't care, because I'm going to speak the word of God. YouTube might take this video down. I don't care. I'm going to do what God says. We need to react the way God would react. Amen. And so what Jesus Christ has made to us is clear is how we were created. Let me say it like this. Default settings is the way that God has intended for us. Now, that being said, anyone that struggles with temptations of maybe homosexuality or temptations feeling like they're the other gender, this video is not being made in hate or condemnation towards them. This video is not being made telling them that they're bad people, telling them that they're horrible, that God hates them, that they're going to hell. Those things aren't true. The truth is that God does love them, that God has created them for a plan and a purpose, and that God is for them. He's not against them. However, we will always believe what the Bible says, and the way God has created us is male and female. Jesus didn't say male and female and whatever else you want to do, because however you feel is your truth, and your truth doesn't mean it's another person's truth, and whatever you want, you can have, and whatever you want, I'm just going to be fine with it. I'm just going to accept. No, he said, God created us male and female. Default settings. Exactly how we were born is how God created us. Now, does that mean you'll never struggle with temptation? You'll never struggle with thoughts or bad feelings? A lot of people will say, well, if God created people this way, why do they feel like they're the opposite gender? Or why do they feel like they weren't born the way that they now feel? And that is because in this world, Satan exists and he gives us temptations. He gives us these bad thoughts. He gives us these very real feelings. But the most important thing we need to learn about God, we are not our temptations. In fact, if you struggle with homosexual temptations, just like if you were to struggle with lustful temptations, they are no different. What you need to understand is you are not your temptation. You are not the bad thought that comes into your mind. I always compare it to like this. If you're walking outside and a bird flies over your head and a bird poops right on your head, now that would be really gross. And you'd be like, oh, that's mega gross, right? I mean, that would be ultra gross, to be honest with you, bro. But anyways, if the bird poops on your head, would you blame yourself? And would you say to yourself, oh my goodness, why did I poop on my head? No, you can't poop on your head, because I'm not going to go into all the details of why you can't poop on your head. But my point is that you cannot poop on your head. Only the bird could poop on your head. The reason I'm telling you this is because the bird is like a thought. You see, the devil in this world, you'll get thoughts, feelings, temptations, and they're going to fly over. Those thoughts, those feelings, those temptations are not who you are. You see, you, if you've given your life to Christ, are a child of God. Now, if you're not a Christian, you still are the way God created you to be. However, you're going to struggle a lot more with those thoughts and temptations. Anyways, I'm saying all this because what you've got to do is you got to take the poop out of your head. Now, am I calling those people that are in the LGBTQ community or people that identify as other genders, am I calling them poop? No, I'm absolutely in no way. They are amazing and God created them. However, God created them male and female. And so those that are born male, that's how God intended it to be. Those that are born female, that's how God intended them to be. Now, when it comes down to the question of, well, should we address them by the right pronoun? Should we do all those things? That is specific to each person. I would highly suggest that you ask God and pray about it yourself. However, I will always tell you this, that it's best to make peace with all men. So in my friendships, in my relationships, if I have a friend that maybe was born a male and God intended them to be a male, but maybe they identify as female, I will ask God and I'll say, God, how do you want me to treat this friend? And typically, if I know that if I say something that will offend them or hurt them, I will stay away. However, if they were to ask me, Gabe, what does God think about this subject? Gabe, what does the Bible say about this subject? I would tell them if they wanted it. But as Christians, we are not called to go parading ourselves, telling everyone that they're right and they're wrong. Because can I be honest with you? If we were called to do that, we would also be called to the sinner and tell them all the wrong things they're doing. We're not called to do that. Instead, we're called to love. In conclusion, the main premise of this video, the main purpose of this video, the main thing that I think God really wants you to take from away from this is, please do not just listen to everyone preaching whatever they want to be preaching. You must go back on the word of God. Now, some people may say, well, Gabe, hasn't this reaction video just been your opinion? No, honey boo boo, it hasn't. It's been God's opinion. It's been what God says. I want to read to you a couple more scriptures. Romans chapter 1 and verse 24. Therefore, God gave them over to their sinful desires of their hearts, sexual impurity for the degrading of the bodies one with another. And 1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 9, it says, do you not know that the wicked will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, adulterers, male prostitutes, homosexual offenders, thieves, greedy, drunkards, slanderers, swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. But notice, it wasn't just homosexuals there. It was everybody that has fallen. Homosexuality, transgenderism isn't a sin that is any worse than any other sin. It's a sin that all of us, or if we've committed one sin, we've committed them all. And so you may not be identified is that, but if you've ever made a mistake, you're in the same pot. And the reason I'm telling you this, and as we close out this video, before you leave, please don't leave yet. I want to again reemphasize how much God loves you, how much not only does he love you, he loves every single person. And Christianity is not for the perfect people. Christianity isn't for the perfect ones. It's for those who recognize their need for a savior. So wherever you are, I'd love to pray this with me. If you would just close your eyes after me and say these words after me. Now, if you're watching this video and you don't want to pray, you can scroll off, but I believe this prayer is God's word for you right now. So close your eyes with me, put your hand on your heart, and say these words after me. Jesus, I love you. Right now, I give you my life. You are Lord. Jesus, I choose to think your thoughts. Thank you for creating me with purpose. From this day forward, I will love others. In your mighty name I pray. Amen, amen, amen. If you want to learn more, or if you gave your life to Christ for the first time, tell me down in the comments down below. If you want to learn how to hear God's voice, how to pray in tongues, a whole bunch of amazing things, those videos are down in the description below. They're completely free, so you should go check them out. Again, this channel is your way to get to know God. If you want to learn more stuff, just click the channel, scroll through the videos. They're all about God. If you're interested in supporting, you can, or some getting some really cool merch. It says, It says Make Jesus Viral, and it says King Jesus too. So we've got made some really cool merch. And so if you want to support the channel, the proceeds help this channel grow. I use it for equipment, our Zooms, our youth groups, and really to reach more kids for the gospel. Those links are down in the description below, and you can go check it out. You can go ask your parents if you want, or maybe you could get it yourself, however you'd like to. If you want to choose to even donate to expand this channel even more, you can, but you don't have to. Only if God puts it on your heart. God loves you. I love you. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is King. Okay, bye, Felicia. Honey boo boo. Peace out.